Ever since we learned of the existence of the Red Planet centuries ago, the thought of it bustling with alien beings has fascinated scientists and the common public. Some pictured a land shaped by an intelligent civilization. Others pictured dark swaths of vegetation, sentient plants, and strange flora and fauna. With the new NASA rovers, some of the most technologically sophisticated spacecrafts, NASA aims to answer one of the oldest questions. Does life exist anywhere but Earth? And what would even happen if we were to find evidence of life or ancient aliens? The Mars of today is not a pleasant place, at least not for life as we know it. It is cold and dry, with a dusty atmosphere and no magnetic field. Its surface is constantly zapped by radiation. But several billion years ago, Mars was likely warm and flourishing with water, with ancient lakes and nutrient-rich soil, and perhaps ancient life. Today, not just NASA, but even private companies are invested in a trip to Mars. Leading the charge is SpaceX, which aims to put humans on Mars by the late 2030s, and eventually to colonize the dead red planet, just like Elon Musk said. Land on Mars, a round-trip ticket, $500,000. It can be done. For scientists searching for extraterrestrial life, Mars provides plenty of hope. Multiple observations over the years, right from the Viking, to Curiosity, Perseverance, indicate signs of life. Recently, AI has also joined the mission to chase aliens. Scientists developed an AI system that has discovered 8 very suspicious radio signals that are intriguingly alien. Well, AI has interestingly also got a spot in hunting extraterrestrial life on the red planet. Yes, you heard it right. Soon, AI will be used to hunt aliens on our red neighboring planet, Mars. But how far will AI succeed in unraveling the secret of extraterrestrial life?
Orbit beyond the blue.
In 1951, the world was introduced to the first artificial intelligence program, which was written by the University of Oxford's programming genius, Christopher Strachey. But very few folks were aware and keen to know about it. Cut to now, where AI and machine learning are taking over major industries, and humans now have a smart companion in almost every walk of life. And, as I told you before, it will also partner in uncovering the mysteries of Martian life. Mars has been a hotspot for researchers, astronomers, and scientists who are relentlessly searching for a tiny piece of evidence that hints towards the fact that Mars is fairly habitable to bear some form of life. It is strongly believed that before the AI makes rounds to Mars for hunting aliens or any kind of life, it should be trained here on Earth first. A team of researchers has successfully trained an AI to map biosignatures on the terrain of the intensely dry and hot Atacama Desert in Chile. What are biosignatures, you ask? Those are any characteristics, elements, molecules, substances, or features that can be used as evidence for the past or present life. Chile's Atacama Desert doesn't necessarily fall under the inhabitable category, but due to its fractal-like ridge networks, patterned ground, and shrinkage cracked terrains of abiotic or biotic origin, the researchers have quoted it as one of the most Mars-like environments on Earth. Time for a quick backstory. Kimberly Warren Rhodes, the team lead of this research, has been hunting biosignatures since the early 2000s when she realized there were barely any tools existed to study the biology of other planets. In 2016, Warren Rhodes' group traveled to the high, parched plateau of the Atacama Desert at an elevation of around 3,500 meters in Chile to look for rock-dwelling, photosynthetic organisms called endoliths. The researchers collected everything from drone footage to geochemical analyses to DNA sequences. Interestingly, This data set mimic the types of information researchers are hunting and collecting on Mars with orbital satellites, drones and rovers. She wanted to combine her background in statistical ecology with emerging technologies like AI to help mission scientists who are under a lot of pressure to find biosignatures with an added struggle of how they do so. Now, if I talk about rovers, they are created to chase biosignatures but are controlled remotely from Earth. They can travel only limited distances and relatively collect few specimens, placing a premium on sampling locations that are the most likely to yield life. Well, you need to see how AI outperforms rovers and, of course, humans. Warren Rhodes' team fed the previously collected data into the AI. The aim was to train the AI to recognize which specific locations on the map might have the highest probability of supporting life. And it worked superbly well. The AI was able to successfully locate life-supporting biosignatures with 56.9 to 87.5% accuracy. With this, the researchers were able to reduce their search area by up to 97%. If this data is overwhelming, then just cut through the clutter and focus on the fact that humans had a success rate of less than 10% in contrast to AI. Now, that difference is huge. The new AI-developed method will need some verification across multiple ecosystems, including those with more complex geology and greater biodiversity. The Atacama Desert is relatively simple in terms of the habitats and the types of life that are likely to be found there. On Mars, the high level of ultraviolet radiation striking the planet's surface means that scientists might need to detect clues that hint at life below ground. To have our team make one of these first steps towards reliably detecting biosignatures using AI is exciting, says research team lead Warren Rhodes. As we have known the red planet, according to previous research and findings, was wetter, warmer, and more habitable than today's parched desert. This remains a challenge for researchers who are working day and night in search of a single hint of life on Mars. One of the most celebrated astronomers, Buzz Aldrin, once said, "Mars is there, waiting to be reached," and these words are sworn by scientists. Right from Mariner 4 to Phoenix Lander to Curiosity rover, NASA has been vigorously pursuing life on Mars. Despite all these efforts, there is still no concrete solution to the most asked question: if Mars is home to alien life. Even if Mars did once host life, the key questions that are keeping scientists up are: how did such life impact the planet? And where could we find evidence for its past existence? John Noble Wilford, the reporter that covered the moon landing for the New York Times, has beautifully described the passion of scientists seeking the red planet. Mars tugs at the human imagination like no other planet. With a force mightier than gravity, it attracts the eye to the shimmering red presence in the clear night sky. The budding AI project is a far-sighted opportunity to pursue life on Mars that will not only give a boost to the hunt, but will also ease a ton of ongoing technological barriers that scientists are facing. Despite all the failed attempts, AI comes in as a ray of hope that researchers are clinging to find alien life. But we need to hang tight until the AI project kickstarts, which will take a fair amount of research, experiments, and tests. And, not to miss, a lot of patience. Till then, we can only wait and think of fascinating theories, our favorite pastime. These questions, though, will always remain unanswered till then. Will the AI progress its way out to detect Martian life? Or will scientists face another form of disappointment? I guess time will tell us the truth. But then again, what do I know?
Beyond the blue.